cherish peace with all my heart. I don't care how many men, women, and children I need to kill to get it.
To me, Peacemaker, he's the saddest character in the whole thing. He has the most difficulty connecting to another human being because he doesn't feel like he belongs.
I think liberty is just your excuse to do whatever you want.
We talked a lot about backstory. James is like, hey man, be like a douchey Captain America who would shoot a kid. Okay, I got it.
Peacemaker.
Starfish is a slang term for a butthole. Think there's any connection?
No.
Peacemaker's a lot of guys I grew up with.
It's just a rash.
That's a rash.
I mean, he is this sort of dude bro. Like a lot of dude bros, he didn't have a great father, didn't have any mother.
His father was a soldier who trained his son how to kill from the moment he was born.
Bloodsport. It's like, I'm the leader. Peacemaker's like, you're the leader.
I always hit my target's dead center.
Hit them more in the center.
It's toxic masculinity at its most toxic.
He just wants to be seen. And there's like a lot of psychological subtext there as well.
You're laughing at me for him. Tighty whities, really?
Now that's just racist.
How sad is he that he feels like he's an outsider in any room that he sits in? He is desperate to be dominant because he doesn't feel like he belongs. You see it when he's sitting in the background of the bus as the other characters are talking and he doesn't say a word.
He's very socially awkward. Something as simple as the uniform hits on the head that this guy has validation problems.
No one likes to show off.
Unless what they're showing off is dope as f-
If you're doing covert ops, you wear something like Idris's character. You try not to be seen. This is a guy who wears a large chrome helmet. Everything is red, white, blue, and yellow. This man genuinely thinks he's a hero and wants his Peacemaker logo on everything.
Every time I look over at John and he's wearing that silver toilet on his head.
A toilet seat, it's a beacon of freedom.
It's the best, you know, it's so ridiculous.
These are the moments, gentlemen, drink them in.
John Cena caught me so unexpectedly. I mean, people think his superpower is that he's super strong and he's a good actor, but his ability to make us all laugh is his superpower.
John Cena's the best improv artist I've ever worked with in my life. And I've worked with a lot of comedians.
Head to the second floor shower, stall 3. 1630 hours. His name's Felipe, but they call him the Bloodhound.
I'm not getting to the shower with you, pal.
While we've been shooting, he's been teaching himself how to play piano? That's crazy to me. He's an alien. And he's like the hugest person I've ever seen in my life. The thing that was most difficult was learning to sword fight in high heels. Shh. Peacemaker's not really as tall as you think he is.
To be able to humanize this character fully and get to the bottom of who he is and what makes him the way he is what drove me to do the TV show with him.
What do you guys want him for?
Just to save the world, that's all.
You're a born killer with expertise in every weapon known to humankind. I'm giving you the chance to stay out of prison and work for me.
Kill people.
Bad people.
A movie, you're spending a limited amount of time with these characters. This show, I get to know so many aspects of their personalities and their relationships.
Why is there a bald eagle in your car?
It's eagle.
Eagly is your pet eagle.
Yeah.
Is your dog named Doggy?
I think it's very different from any of these other superhero shows. It kind of sits in its own little world that takes stuff that we did that was risky in Suicide Squad and kind of takes it much further. First episode. They've hired Peacemaker. They know he's a trained killer. They've brought him in to do the bad stuff that they don't want to do.
No, lately I'm just like a maniac.
Hey, no!
No!
Peacemaker was in prison for years. We're living in a different world.
Hey, Sweet Cheeks. Can you take my order real quick?
Sweet Cheeks. Seriously, dude.
She had cherubic cheeks. It's a compliment.
Peacemaker is a guy who just doesn't belong. Doesn't belong with his dad. He doesn't belong with this group of black ops. He feels completely outside of them. The only one that Peacemaker has any sort of bond with is his pet eagle.
Oh my God, he's hugging me.
And that's really him.
He's hugging me.
Dad, grab my phone, I don't want to move.
When you're talking about a TV series that could last for many seasons, I think that we want to start with kind of the guy that's the worst because he has the biggest changes to make. The Peacemaker show is a tent, held up by a lot of different stands. And the stands are humor, heart, and action. really is about being with the characters first and foremost. And that's what's so fun for me to do this show.